For those of you short on time, here's the Reader's Digest condensed version of this video. Mac user, you are f***ed. Own a PC that's more than a couple of years old? F***ed. Recently bought a new computer for basic or mid-level gaming? You're f***ed too. Basically, the majority of us are f***ed. Want to get un-f***ed in time for your virtual reality headset to arrive? Today, I'm covering the Oculus Rift's recommended specs, which covers you HTC Vive users too, and what they ultimately mean to your virtual reality experience. And I promise not to drop any more F-bombs in this video. The minimum recommended specs for the Oculus Rift are actually pretty simple. You need a video card at least as powerful as the GTX 970 or AMD 290. You need at least an Intel i5-4590 processor, which is a quad-core 3.3 GHz processor with max turbo up to 3.7 GHz. You need at least 8 GB of RAM, finally an easy one. You need to be running your PC on Windows 7 Service Pack 1 or newer. If you're running all of these other specs and aren't 90 years old, that's pretty much a gimme. You need at least two USB 3.0 ports, and this is the only tricky one. You need a graphics card that has HDMI 1.3 video output supporting a 297 MHz clock via direct output architecture. The tricky part, particularly if you have a gaming laptop, is a direct output architecture. Manufacturers don't clearly lay that out in their specs, so what's the best way to know for sure whether or not your computer can run the Oculus Rift? Go to the Oculus website, click the button to pre-order your Rift or add it to your cart, and there will be a blue notice at the top of your cart where you can download their compatibility tool. Download it, run it, and find out for sure whether or not you're good to go. The really nice thing here is that Oculus has promised these specs will hold true throughout the life cycle of the Rift. But what if you want the ultimate virtual reality experience? Will the minimum specs provide an optimal experience? The answer is no. And that's why you see several Oculus-ready options that have an i7 processor instead of an i5, 16 gigabytes of RAM, and a GTX 980 instead of a GTX 970. The value drops off a bit for some of these, particularly between the GTX 970 and GTX 980, but you'll receive an indisputably better virtual reality experience running an i7 and a GTX 980 than someone running an i5 and a GTX 970. So if you ultimately decide to spring an extra $400 or so like I did, you'll absolutely have a better virtual reality experience than the recommended specs. Now get out there and upgrade your PC so that we can all watch virtual reality porn together. Well, not together, because that would be awkward. I did that once with a friend in middle school and yeah, I don't want to talk about it. On a less psychologically painful note, I hope this video answered all of your questions. If so, give it a thumbs up below and don't forget to subscribe so that you're notified of my future videos. If you have any questions or feedback, leave them in the comment section below and I'll do my best to reply within the next 24 hours. My name is Ian, I am the virtual reality ginger, and I'm trying to make virtual reality easy to understand for everyone. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in another video soon.